Okay, I just took a picture. And for all of you watching, I'm gonna put it up on screen so you can see what it looks like whenever we're playing the game.
This isn't even me drifting. I'm just going doing donuts.
Now you do own a Jeep.
Hold on, I'm going back to the snow area.
Wait. Oh, now you're... Yeah, the vehicle double in size. It's gonna be good to...
Hold on, let's try drifting.
Explore the tundra.
Skrrr! Yeah, take that, Drift King. More like Drift Prince, because there's a new king in town. Boom. Secret snow area. Look, you can see it from like a mile away.
Yeah.
But it's a secret, so.
So don't tell anyone.
Yeah. Not that anyone's gonna watch this video and tell their friends about Lawnmower Game. This is 2 episodes, right?
Well, it's been 26 minutes, so it's probably 30. If you were a viewer, would you have a retention to this game for longer than, like, 5 or 10 minutes? Probably not.
I wouldn't watch the video, I'd listen to it. Oh?
I don't know. I think these could be 10-minute episodes.
I got stuck.
You're not stuck. You can move. I see that wheel moving.
It looks like J. Jonah Jameson.
Is that why you're in the mountains to find Spider-Man? Is that why you're so, like, determined to be...
I know Spider-Man's up this mountain! I need to find him for the Daily Bugle.
This is so unentertaining, but so fun. No, please. Look.
Why is that yellow?
What?
There's the line between the...
It's not yellow.
It looks yellow. It looks
I
like...
I think you're blind.
You're right.
It's a blue-white.
I think it's just the TV tint.
Oh, I see it. It's supposed to be a light.
Oh, okay, I was thinking it looked like pee.
It's like reflecting light, like it's a light thing.
Oh, I have to double my distance to get the turbo mower. Do we want to play that long to get the turbo mower? I think we have to at this point.
Okay. Look, just grind it out. Okay, just...
we're going to the classic.
Just drive forward. And then, like, back. Like you.
Yeah,
just don't...
I'm holding forward.
You're not hitting those max speeds. I think you need to get a different one, because I don't think 28, 29 is going to cut it. You're not going to get a different mower. I don't think this will cut it. Oh, really? Is there a go fast button? Have you looked at that?
I can turn on the lights.
What do you mean? The detail in this game, bro.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. I think the second one might go the fastest. Maybe this is like a truck. Once you get it going, it's good. Oh, we're cooking.
33. It's around the same speed as the other one.
Yeah, you gotta check on the second one too, in case we're missing out.
Yeah.
If I'm gonna spend the next 15 minutes, if I'm gonna spend the next 25 minutes grinding points.
Podcast episode 2!
If I'm gonna spend the next 15 minutes grinding out points, it's gonna be on the fastest mower that you can find. Oh, he wants to help us get distance too. This one feels fast.
I don't think it matters which mower we use.
No, you see, it's different. They programmed it.
Oh, this one's going 34.
You're not gonna make it. Oh, you made it.
Watch this.
I'm gonna be a...
You're gonna be a what?
Oh, I'm watching this tree service vehicle drive by. All right. 100% honest with you.
Uh-huh.
Lawnmower Game, The Next Generation. When did this game come out? This is version 1.
Wait, that's the wrong button. Oh, wait, 2019. 2019 on Switch, 2015 in general, it looks like. Oh, wait, no. These are all the people who made the... You might want to censor these.
Why?
Those are the people who made the assets that he's flipping.
What's wrong with that?
I don't know. I just don't know if we want to show all that.
I mean, it's published by Nintendo.
Yeah.
So this game came out in 2019.
Probably. Oh, wait, I can just...
When did Pokemon Sword and Shield come out? You gotta let me finish this. When did it come out?
2020. Oh, this came out last year.
These people did so much better programming distance and render. They have less frame drops. Where are you going? They have less frame drops than Pokemon Sword and Shield. They have a better story. It makes more sense. I understand the story of this more. Okay, I still don't even understand Rose's intention. Look, less frames, more sensical story. And look at the way things in the distance get bigger as you get closer to them rather than just popping up out of nowhere. Right?
Yeah.
They could have done that with the Pokemon.
They sure could have.
We need to show Nintendo those people whose assets were used so they can hire them.
I'm sure they've seen it. They had to publish this. They had to look at this game and say, yep, this on our eShop.
You think Game Freak looked at the copyrights on Lawnmower Next Generation?
And snapped them up for the next game? Scarlet and Violet gonna be lit. This video is going to come out after Scarlet and Violet.
Unless it gets delayed. Can I tell the people when we're recording this?
I think I already did.
We're recording this on June 14th, 2022.
Pokemon's not going to delay their game.
And the legendaries were just revealed
a few, like a week ago.
So for your frame of reference, this is around the time the legendaries were revealed.
Yeah.
Like right after.
Same month.
So, what predictions are we gonna make?
Oh,
now
that's true.
Now that we've established that we're
this is our podcast episode.
Now that we're talking to the future people.
We're talking
to the next generation.
I didn't even move. Why did it move?
You should set the controller on the table and then mow some grass. It's picking up all of it.
Okay, so
I'm gonna triple the volume at that point.
Pokemon predictions.
Next generation of Pokemon.
The next generation of Pokemon. I think the games are going to be okay.
You know what? I think people are going to shout out two white guys because of that prediction right there. I think people
Did you see that?
You know, that one, that white guy number one is white guy number one because he deserves it because he did say Pokemon Scarlet.
Why are there crosses?
All right. What do you mean? It's a cemetery.
Oh, never mind.
With cows.
There's like three crosses. It's like Golgotha.
Don't tell Gotha tell about it.
You know, it's like the Hill of Golgotha where they crucified Jesus. Why are there three crosses? You know, like they had Jesus in the middle and the two thieves on the sides?
Lawnmower Game really out here for real, for real.
This game is actually an allegory for Christian themes. It's like Evangelion, if you think about it.
So.
Wait.
I think Pokemon, Scarlet and Violet. This is not where you should have stopped moving. With your head clipped in the mountain. You know what? The head clippage actually makes it look like that's just your head shape.
Kinda, yeah.
If you long enough.
I thought there was an, I thought there was an Evangelion thing called Next Generation. I was about to get hype, but...
I gotta talk to the people here, okay? You're only two-thirds of the way. Pokemon Scarlet and Violet.
Mm-hmm.
There are going to be videos made by, you know, what are they? A-Drive, Austin Jump, you know, all those kinds of people.
Yeah.
Patty, Trill, these could probably make a video. All these people are going to make videos.
They sure are.
Peachell, too, he's going to make videos. They're all going to have these videos, and they're going to be like, look, it's going to be the same thing with Paper Mario. Where people made videos about Paper Mario and they go, you see, we've been frustrated at the franchise and we've not been wanting to play the Paper Mario games, but we believe Origami King is moving in the right direction.
And then it doesn't?
Like, after it came out and they played the game. Because people want partners.
Yeah.
Because in the other two, you get Goombario, you get,
Koops.
You get Goombella, you get other Koops whose literally name is Koop and then Cooper.
The kid Yoshi.
You get Seymour 55.
Yeah, you get partners, yeah.
You get all these people, right? No one in the world can forget Vivian. The game came
as
out
as much as you try to.
The game came out in 2002, 2007, something like that. I think it was 2007, and they had a transgender character.
Yeah.
Like,
good for that game. Happy Pride.
I'm not saying that's good or bad. I mean, I think that's cool, especially as Pride Month, right?
Yeah, especially like for 2002.
I think it was 7 for the Thousand Year Door.
Was it 7? Wasn't the Wii out by then?
Yeah.
I thought you just said 2002. I'm mishearing.
No, I did. I said both of them.
Oh, I'm almost out of gas.
Let me see. Paper Mario: The Thousand Year Door published in 2004.
Okay, we were both wrong.
I knew it was somewhere in the 2004 or 2007 range. Or 2002, I mean. So, yeah, because it came out with Sunshine, which was 2002.
Okay.
The point is, everyone, that's what people are going to say about Scarlet and Violet. They're going to be like, look, because people were saying Origami King is moving in the right direction because they gave us partners in Origami King. And it wasn't Color Splash, and it wasn't Sticker Star, where you had to fight with stickers. Like, they improved the battle mechanics a little bit by making it more unique. Like,
right.
They tried.
But
and
the
they
point
made it, they is... even made it a little bit more RPG-like than the other ones.
Right.
Because you still don't have to fight people. Because in these past Paper Mario games, you don't have to fight people to level up. You can just ignore every single
one. Right, I played Sticker Star.
And I think that's what they're doing with Scarlet and Violet. I think they're just moving in the right direction. I don't think it's going to be the new original best Pokemon games, you know, because some people say Black and White were the last good Pokemon game. Some people say it was Diamond and Pearl. Some people say it was X and Y.
I think people say that the last good Pokemon game was the one that they first played.
Which is, they just say it's whatever their favorite one is for the most part.
And it's usually the one they first played.
Yeah. But if you look... There is a point where you look at Black and White, you look at X and Y, you look at Alpha Sapphire and Ruby. Like, you look at the games, and then you see the transition from DS to Switch, and you can see the drop. Because Sun and Moon also came out, I forgot about that.
Yeah, I like Sun.
Like, you can look at the DS games... And you can look at the Switch games and tell a difference in the quality of the games.
Yeah, it's because, you know, Game Freak wasn't used to working
yeah.
with that kind
Which,
of...
I'm not hating on Game Freak or making fun of them for it, but you can tell right, that was it's there.
Just wasn't their strong suit.
And I think that, I'm not saying Game Freak made all these, I'm not talking about anything, but I'm just saying, for Game Freak and just Pokemon in general, they had Sword and Shield, which was the first learning experience, I think. Or no, they had Let's Go.
Yeah, Let's Go looked good.
They had Let's Go, which was their first, which is a, which basically looked like this.
Did it? I feel like Sword and Shield looked worse than Let's Go.
I'm pretty sure Let's Go was, like, very plain.
Stylistically.
Yeah.
Maybe not just, graphically, but at least plain. Stylistically.
But,
because there is a difference.
They had, no one cares anymore. They all clicked off the video. Sword and Shield. Then they had Legends, Arceus. Is there another Pokemon game? Like a main one?
It wasn't made by Game Freak, but BDSP.
Yeah, BDSP.
So I'm stuck because I ran over a fire pit.
They have Let's Go, Sword and Shield, BDSP, Arceus.
Right.
Those are the games. I think that's enough for Scarlet and Violet to be the turning point for Game Freak to be making better, more quality games.
At least
Pokemon.
Graphically.
Pokemon, at least. Graphically, yeah.
Yeah. Not, like, their story still probably won't improve, because that's just been a thing.
Watching the trailer, it upsets me, and it's embarrassing to be a Pokemon fan. Because there were frame drops in the trailer. Multiple times on the first initial release trailer.
That's not really a graphics issue, though. That's a performance issue, but that's neither here nor there. I'm just pointing that out.
And the graphics weren't, like, the best either.
They looked better. Like, the Pokemon are more detailed. Like, that one clip of Sivir scales.
No, I agree. The Pokemon are it's amazing Pokemon graphics for Pokemon. But it's mid graphics for normal anything else.
Right.
I will tell you something. If Mario Sunshine came out for the Switch, like Mario Sunshine 2.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That game would be gorgeous. The water, the sand, just the paint, everything in that game would be beautiful. It would look amazing. The sky, it would look just like you're on vacation. And that's going to be on the same system and console as this Pokemon Scarlet and Violet, which is terrible and awful.
Yeah, just even look at just like Mario Odyssey, which is already almost 5 years old.
What is it, 2017?
Yeah. It was like November 2017. That's already almost like 5 years old, and it looks so much better than these games.
It still looks better than Scarlet and Violet. Look, I'm a Mario Sunshine fan. Don't hate me. I'm not saying I hate Galaxy. I don't have a problem with Galaxy. I like Galaxy. I'm allowed to like two games, okay, that are compared and similar.
I was actually going to mention Galaxy because I was looking at... I was getting a render of Peach off the Mario Wiki so I could put it in one of our thumbnails.
I just like Sunshine more, but I think they're both really good games. They're fun.
It never really hit me how, like, graphically different Galaxy is from other Mario games in terms of, like, texturing and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Until I was looking at the renders of Peach and just sitting in the middle of all the, like, really bright and cartoony renders is just, like, more, like, realistically colored, like... more faded looking model of Peach, and it was from Galaxy, and it never really struck me how graphically distinct Galaxy is as a Mario game.
That's part of the reasons why I just like it so much. It's just so nice to look at.
Galaxy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Galaxy. It's just looking at it, it just hits different on the eyes.
Yeah, I haven't played Galaxy in a long time. I beat it when I was a kid. But I liked it. I never did. I played Galaxy 2, but I never beat it.
We should just play Galaxy on the channel.
Okay.
Galaxy.
I have the Mario collection.
I do too.
Wow.
You remember the thing that was limited time and is still in the stores and the shelves?
Yeah. It's been like a year since they took it off shelves, but they're still selling it.
Yeah, well, no one bought it.
Joke's on you to all the people who tried to sell it for like $50 bajillion on
they
eBay.
They really did too. And I'm sure some people
like,
bought it.
You can't find the Mario Game & Watch anymore, but you could for, like, months and months. But I still see, like, and I go in Walmart, and they have, like, 6 Zelda Game & Watches.
I don't know. Long story. You're the exact same color as that mountain. Like, the back of your vehicle. You see it? Like, your gray vehicle.
It's not my fault.
I don't know. I'll blame you. Look, Scarlet and Violet is going to be moving in the right direction graphically, and it's going to be a better game performance-wise, and I think it's going to be more enjoyable than the past games have been. Now, yeah. I'm not going to compare this to Arceus.
Yeah, Arceus is probably one of my favorite Pokemon games now.
I'm going to compare this to an RPG Pokemon game.
Right, because that's what it's trying to be.
Yes, like a strictly RPG, not this open world, throw a Pokemon wherever you want to.
Kind of. It's more traditional RPG and less action RPG.
I'm pretty sure the Pokemon sizes in this game are going to be realistic.
I hope.
And I'm pretty sure, like from the trailers, it seemed that way. And I'm also pretty sure they're going to have Pokemon follow you.
Oh, please.
Because when I watched the trailer,